In the previous video, we understood how to calculate the cycle time and minimum number of workstations required to do the assembly of the electrical appliance. Okay, so we got the value of cycle time, that is TC, 1 minute. We got 1 minute, and minimum number of workstations required, that is 4 numbers. So these two calculations are very important to allocate the different parts of the electrical appliance to different machines to balance the automated production line. So here we have a table. So in this table, the first column is station number. Okay, so we are going to use different number of machines. To those machines, we are going to assign the work elements. There are 12 work elements. These work elements we are going to allocate to different machines. The first column is the station number. In this column, I'll write the station number 1, or the machine number 1, machine number 2, machine number 3, machine number 4, machine number 5, like this. The second table, I'll write the work elements number, that is 1, 3, 6, 9. Okay, so like this, we have 12 work elements. Those work elements number, whenever I assign or allocate to the station number 1, 2, 3, I'll write it in the second column. TK is the, what is the total time required to assemble the one work element, or to allocate, okay, whenever it is allocated to the station number 1, I'll write it in the third column as the TK in minutes. And station time, that is the total time or total TK time, okay, so according to the work elements assigned to the station number 1, 2, 3, okay, so all these work elements time, that is TK value, will add up, and we'll write it in the fourth column as a total station time in minutes. And this is the precedence diagram. This diagram I'm going to use to allocate the work elements into different machines or the stations to do the assembly operation. So we can clearly understand by using this precedence diagram, and we can do the allocation of work elements to different machines. So before going to do the allocation of work elements to different workstations or machines, first we have to understand two important conditions. One is we have to allocate the work elements to machines according to the sequence in which the precedence diagram the work elements are shown. So according to that only we have to allocate, or according to the problem, okay, in the given problem. So according to that only we have to allocate the work elements into different machines. So next, another condition that we calculated is the cycle time. That cycle time, okay, is 1 minute. So here, the whatever the station time column we have, that is the last column, in this we'll add all the TK values of work elements assigned to the different stations or machines. That time should be equal to 1 minute, that is the cycle time, or less than 1 minute. It should not exceed the 1 minute. So that is the second condition. So now we'll start assigning the work elements to different machines or the stations. So here, in the precedence diagram, so element number 1, or the work element number 1, and work element number 2 are the two beginning stations, beginning work parts to be assembled, or the elements we have to start. Okay, so here this work element number 1 is having 0.2 minute of TK value, and work element number 2 is having 0.4 minute of TK value. So when you compare these two, work element number 2 is having more value, that is 0.4 minute. Okay, so according to the largest candidate rule, we have to take the TEK value which is larger first, and we have to allocate to the first machine. So I'll write the station number 1, and I'll take the second work element because it is having 0.4 minute. When you compare with the work element number 1, these two are the beginning work elements. So, and it's having a TEK value of 0.4 minutes. Okay, so this is done. After assigning this or allocating this, the arrow mark is moving, and we can start the work element number 4, but the work element number 1 is not done, or it is not completed. So we cannot allocate, or we cannot assign this to machine number 1. When you complete this work element number 2, it is already assigned and it is completed. The work element number 5 is, okay, we can assign. We can assign this also, because before this, we have work element number 2, that is done. So that, okay, so available option is work element number 5 and work element number 1. Okay, so work element number 1 is having 0.2 minute of TK value, and it is having 0.3. So that, which is larger, the fifth work element is having larger TK value. So we can assign this to machine number 1. Okay, so this is done. After completing this, we can assign this also, but we have to complete 8 also. After completing 8 and 5, we can assign 10, but 8 is not completed. So here we can assign 4 also, because 2 is completed, but okay, after completing 1 and 2 only, we can assign 4. So we cannot assign the 4 now. So available is, okay, the first work element that is available to assign, because before this we don't have any other work element to be completed. So we can assign work element number 1. Okay, so it's having the processing time or the TK value of 0.2 minute. So now this is done. Okay, so now, so these two are done, work element number 2 and 4. After completing 1 and 2, we can start 4. So now it is satisfied. Okay, the condition is satisfied, and we can assign this also, because 1 is completed. So after completing 1, we can start 3 also. When you compare these two, okay, these are the two available options. So 4 is having, work element 4 is having 0.1 minute of TK value, and 3 is having 0.7. If you assign this, okay, 0.7 is larger, but if you assign this 0.7 minute with the work element number 3 here, it will exceed 1 minute value. So what I'll do is I'll take the fourth one and I'll assign or allocate to machine number 1, and the time is 0.1 minute. So when you add all these, okay, TEK value of work element number 2, 5, 1, 4, so we'll get 1 minute of time. Okay, 4 plus 3, 7 plus 2, that is 9 plus 1, that is 1 minute. Okay, so this is done. So next I'll go to the second machine or the station number 2, and I'll assign the next work element. So now the available option, that is, okay, if you take work element number 8, okay, 4 is done, so that we can assign this also, but here 3 should be completed to assign the work element number 8 to the machine number 2, and here 8 should be completed to assign the work element number 10 to the machine number 2. This is not possible, but 3 can be assigned, because work element number 1 is done, so that before this we don't have any other work element to be completed. So this is the beginning one here, after completing 1, so that we can assign work element number 3 to machine number 2 with a TEK value of 0.7 minute. This is done. So now this is done. Okay, so after completing this, we are getting the work element number 8. Okay, work element number 8. Okay, so that we can assign, but it's having a 0.6. Okay, because 4 is completed and 3 is also completed. The next, okay, so this one will begin. So this one we cannot assign, because it's having 0.6 minute of TK value. So it will exceed 1 minute. So the available is 6th work element, okay, and 7th work element. Okay, these are all the two work elements available, okay, options. So when you compare these two, it is having 0.32 minute and it is having 0.11 minute, okay, which is larger. So the work element 7 is larger, having larger TEK value, but if you assign here, it will exceed 1 minute. Okay, 0.7 and 0.32, it becomes 1.2 minutes. Okay, so it should be 1 minute or within 1 minute. So I'll take the 6th one. 6th one is the better option to assign here. So I'll take 6th work element here and I'll assign to the machine number 2, that is, okay, 0.11 minute. Okay, so this is done. So now it's having the total time of total station time, that is 0.81 minute. 0.81 minute. So this is the total time. So here this is done, but to assign the work element 9, okay, 7 should be completed. Okay, so again 8 should be completed. Okay, 6 is completed, but these two should be completed to assign the next work element. Okay, so this is the this one. So next we'll go to the next machine, that is third machine I'll take, and I'll try to assign the work elements to the third station or the machine. So here to assign this also we can assign, okay, because 3 is completed and 4 is completed, and we can assign this also because 3 is completed. Okay, so which is having larger time? So 8 is having larger time, that is 0.6. So I can assign here 0.6. Okay, is the TK value. So this is done. Okay, so after completing this and this, the 10 is available. Okay, so 10 we can assign to machine number 3. That is possible, and we can assign this also. Okay, we can assign this also. So when you assign this, okay, 10, when you compare this work element number 10 and work element number 7, so the 10 is having more time, so that we can take 10. Okay, it is larger, so the time is larger for the 10th work element. So I can assign to this machine. So the total station time, if you assign further any work element, it will exceed the total 1 minute time. So it is 0.98. Okay, so next we'll go to the fourth machine, and this is done. So here we can assign this one is done, right? So now we can assign this work element, that is 7th one. Okay, so we can assign this also, but 9 should be completed. 10 is completed, but 9 should be completed to assign to the machine. But 9th is not completed, so available is 7th one only. So I'll assign 7 here. Okay, so TK value is 0.32, that is the total TK value. So to TK value of 7th work element. So this is done. Okay, so this is done, this is done, and this is done. We can start this. Okay, so that I can assign the work element number 9 to machine number 4. It's having a time of 2.7 TK value. Okay, so this is done. So now you can assign this also to this, okay, machine, but it will exceed the 1 minute time. So I'll stop this here and I'll calculate the total time. Okay, so what is the total station time? That is, okay, sorry. So that is, okay, so 9, okay, 0.59. So 0.59, that is the total station time. So next, we can assign any other work element also. We can assign this 11th work element, but it will exceed the 1 minute time. So I'll go to the next station, that is station number 5 or machine number 5. So remaining work element is 11 and 12. We can start 11 also. We can, after completing 11, we can start 12 also. So I'll assign 11 here with 0.59 of time. 0.59. Okay, sorry. So 0.59, that is the TK value of work element number 11. Okay, so next, the remaining, this is done. Okay, so this is done and this is done. This is also done, and remaining is 12th work element. Okay, so 12th work element I will assign here, and having the time of 0.12. Okay, so now we can calculate the total time. 0.71. Okay, so now the allocation of work elements into different workstations is done. So okay, this is how we can allocate the work elements into different machines to balance the automated production line. So finally, I think you understood how to do this, and finally we have to do some small calculation. So this is already done. Just we can compare, so both are same, I think. Okay, so now we have to do a small calculation, that is to calculate the balance delay. So we have to use this formula, NTC minus TWC N into TC. So the total number of workstations we got as 5, okay, and TC is 1 minute. And again, number of TWC, that is the total work quantity, is 4 minute, divided by N into TC, that is 5 into 1. So you'll get 0.20, so that is equal to 20%. The balance delay, okay, or wastage of time due to the movement of the workpiece in the automated production line, when you get 5 machines, okay, it is around 20% of wastage. So that is called the balance delay in the automated production line. So this is how we can calculate different parameters of the largest candidate rule. By using largest candidate rule, we can calculate and we can balance the automated production line. So I think you understood. Okay, if you have any doubts, we can clear the doubts with the Google Meet. Thank you, all of you.